Looking for more programs to spice up your computer workflow? Curious about new things to try or new tools to add to your arsenal? Look no further than this series. Here are 5 programs I recommend in no particular order. I'll probably be releasing new episodes to these on a monthly or every other month basis, so stay tuned if you're interested in more.
Useful tech education and gaming nostalgia that won't put you to sleep. Get subscribed and turn on notifications so you won't miss the next guide.
Again, no programs in this video have sponsored me and I've had no contact with their developers. Instead, today's sponsor is...
TubeBuddy is the best tool you can get to manage your YouTube channel. You can update videos in bulk, optimize your SEO, syndicate to social media, back up your metadata, and more, all with a simple browser extension. Head to eposvox.com/TubeBuddy to learn more and download it for free.
First up, we have RealVNC. VNC itself is a protocol for remotely accessing and controlling computers, be it over your home network or over the internet. RealVNC is a great option for managing and controlling your systems remotely. They offer some professional level versions of their tools, which add more enterprise level management for IT professionals and the like, but they also offer a free version that's basic and great for power users like myself at home. I use it to manage my servers and other desktops from anywhere in the world, with multiple layers of password protection and security in place to prevent tampering. It's insanely responsive and provides a high quality render of the desktop without the video desktop driver issues I have with Windows Remote Desktop or the security issues of TeamViewer. And it runs on Linux as well as Windows and Mac, I believe. So win, win, win for me. Taking screenshots is something I do many, many times, almost every day. For that, I need a super convenient tool that still delivers high quality shots and some good options. The perfect balance I have found is with LightShot. LightShot is incredibly easy to use and fast, requiring at most one extra click, press hitting hit print screen to upload, save, or copy a screenshot. It's got a built-in editor, which allows you to adjust the size of the screenshot, draw, highlight, type on it, and so on, quickly and easily. Or you can have it automatically upload the screenshot to share online. I use this daily. It's a key part of my workflow. LightShot is available for Windows and Mac with browser extensions also available. As someone who regularly builds and manages multiple beefy computers at a time, monitoring system temperatures is of the utmost importance. For that, I use CoreTemp. CoreTemp is a great program that monitors your system voltages and temperatures. It lets you keep an eye on how hot your processor is running. It also lets you minimize it to the system tray and just shows temperature readouts in the tray. It's pretty handy and is important when you're constantly pushing your processor to its limits. The next program is pretty important for us night owls, but also the bane of my existence as someone who randomly needs to record my screen for videos. Flux automatically adjusts your screen color brightness throughout the day, primarily reducing its blue light to prevent eye strain and keep you working late into the hours of the night without issue. I used to use gamer glasses for this, but now I just rely on Flux. The problem is this is a system-wide change and not something inherent to your monitor, though some monitors have begun experimenting with this kind of feature. So when I go to record my screen and forget to disable Flux, the footage has a reddish hue to it that I can't really fix in editing. But it's great, quick, and easy to set up, and helps reduce my eye strain quite a bit. Lastly, we have JDownloader 2, also available on a wide variety of operating systems. This is a fantastic download tool for downloading from typical file sharing websites, media streaming sites, and so on. This is easy to pull images, videos, and sound effects or full Open Directory downloads just by copying the URL. It also has some other great features which I can't actually discuss here. And that's it for this installment. Haha, pun. What did you think? Any programs you're going to pick up and use? Comment below. Otherwise, hit the like button if you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode.
This video is sponsored by viewers like you. Our videos would not be possible without the generosity of those of you who contribute to one of our fan funding options, be it DonorBox, Twitch subscriptions, direct contributions via PayPal, or Patreon. To join our inner circle and get behind-the-scenes looks at videos, go to eposvox.com/support to learn more, and join us on Discord at eposvox.com/discord. Thanks!